Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to open zip files on an iPhone. All right, let's get started. All right, first we need to download a file from Etsy. Now, we cannot do this in the Etsy app. You can either go to Safari or Chrome and get them that way. I'll click on Chrome. I'm going to type in Etsy.com, which I already have, so it's up there. And now, if you haven't logged in already, you'll want to do that. And then you'll click on your little picture up here, or your profile image, whichever it is. And then we'll come down here to purchases and reviews. Scroll down through your purchases until you see the one you want, and then you can just click on that. Then you'll scroll down a little more and you'll see the download files button. We'll click that. And then in this file, I've got two zip files, but I'm only gonna download the first one, so I'll click on that button. And then you'll see at the bottom, it'll say download. Go ahead and click that. Now it might take a little bit of time, but once it's finished, you'll want to choose Open In, and then we'll choose Save to Files. I'm going to click on my iPhone and come up here to the top right and choose Save. Next, we'll want to open a different app called Files. Now, if you don't have the Files app, you'll want to download that from the App Store too, and it's free. Okay, and here we can see the zip that we just downloaded. So I'm going to tap that and then choose Preview Content. Now I'll come down here to these three little lines and tap that. Now I can choose which one I want to open, and I want to open the 8x10. Next, we'll come down here to Share This. And you might be tempted to save it as an image, but don't do that. Go ahead and Save to Files. I'm going to tap on my iPhone again and Save. Next, we'll want to open the Cricut app. And again, if you don't have that one, you'll need to download that from the App Store. All right, we'll go ahead and start a new project and then choose Upload here at the bottom. Then we can browse files. If you have Recent selected down here, you can choose your most recent file, which is the one you just saved. Now, mine is not an SVG file, so it's not going to behave the same way. But if yours is an SVG, then you'll have all the layers you need and everything you would normally have with an SVG file. And that's it. Just insert it into the project.
All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, you can hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.